Okay, so we are having one of the prose lesson. So for our syllabus, that is shyness, my shield. So you know that what is the meaning of shy?
Sigu.
Sigu. So what is the meaning of the shield?
Kavacham.
Kavacham. So how the sigu kavacham? Sigu yala kavacham untundi? Shyness, my shield. Sigu anatundi oka kavacham laga tayar ayyindi. How it has become as a shield to our writer, we will see that. So, Shyness My Shield is one of the extraction taken from the autobiography written by Mahatma Gandhi. You know that Mahatma Gandhi is one of the freedom fighter and he is called as the father of the nation. So, he is born in Gujarat in 1869. So, this is about his birth and where he has born. So, we know that what is the autobiography? Autobiography is written by oneself. So, we know that this autobiography is called as, what is the name of the autobiography? My Experience with the Truth. So, Gandhiji has written his own autobiography, what has happened in his life. He has sketched everything, what is happening in his life, as a one of the book he has written. So that book name is My Experience with the Truth. So from that we have a small portion of Shyness My Shield. This is the one of the point which he speaks about this, that means how the shyness became his shield. So we will see this one. So we have a prose lesson, this one. So this contains one kind of story, how he has overcome from the fear of speaking in the public places and how his fear of speaking became has a shield for him and how he was succeeded in his whole life, you will see. So Shyness My Shield is one of the incidents, that means three incidents which happened in his life when he was in England. So there we have one kind of, that means there is one society which is called a vegetarian society in London. Gandhiji also one of the member in that vegetarian club. So we know that any club will be having a financial support from someone else. Here also we have a financial support of the vegetarian club society, that is Mr. Hicks. He is a financial supporter of the vegetarian club and he is the owner of the Thames Iron Board Works, and he is the proprietor of the Thames Iron Works, and he is also a Puritan. We know that what is the meaning of the Puritan. So one who believes in the Bible or go with the biblical things. And another character also is there in that. So his name is Dr. Allison. So he is also one of the member of the vegetarian club and he is an advocate and also he is a member of birth control movement in London. So these are the two points that we have to remember, the two characters. Mr. Hills is one of the financial supporter of the vegetarian club and he is the owner of the Thames Iron Works and he is a Puritan. And another character is Dr. Allison. He is one of the member of vegetarian club and he is an advocate and also he is a member of birth control movement in London. So this is the characters that we have. And here an incident happened in a vegetarian club or vegetarian society that Mr. Hills proposed that he wants to dismiss Dr. Allison from the society or excommunicate him from this society. So the reason is that as a Puritan he has a different kind of opinion on the birth control movement. So he was against the birth control movement and he wants to excommunicate or remove Dr. Allison from the vegetarian club society. This proposal was kept in front of the all of the vegetarian club members. But many of them are not willing to sent back Dr. Allison from the Vegetarian Club Society. So, in the same way, our writer Gandhiji also had a good opinion upon the Dr. Allison and also on the Mr. Hills. And he wants to support Dr. Allison, saying that so we are as a vegetarian society members or vegetarian club members, we are concerned with the only the vegetarian people or vegetarian things, and we are no more concerned about the morals or the values of the others or the cultural of the others. So there is no personal issues cannot be taken into our society. So he wants to support Dr. Allison with this view, and he wants to speak in that meeting or in that gathering. But he was prepared very well, but he was not able to succeed in that speech. He was failed. So his fear or his tamarind have made him not to speak in that public speech. So this is the first incident where Gandhiji failed to speak in the public. So this is the first incident happened in his life. And there is another incident also taken place in his life. That is where this happened. It is in a Vegetarian. So one of the Vegetarian Club members invited Gandhiji to the their area, that is a which area? That is a Vegetarian. So there he was given an opportunity to speak in the gathering. There also he has prepared very well, and he wants to promote the Vegetarian Club or Vegetarian Society about the vegetarian views, and he has prepared a good speech also. And everybody is given a chance to speak there, but unfortunately when the term of Gandhiji has come, he was stood up and he couldn't speak properly, and he has to hand over the what he has written in the paper to his friend Majdoor. So and his friend Majdoor has to read out the entire the message or the speech which is written by Gandhiji. So and this is the second incident where our Gandhiji failed in speaking in the public places. And there is another incident which took place in his life, the third incident. The third incident is happened in one of the restaurants when he was leaving London. So before leaving to London, he has gathered, he has given a farewell party to his friends, and he has given a party in the one of the restaurants. So there everybody was gathered and everybody was having so talks. So we know that so when we are having a farewell party, what are the things that will be happening? So we will be having songs or dances or speeches and everything. In the same way, in that gathering also, everybody is enjoying with all the things. There are cultural activities and everything. And at the last, everybody has given a chance to speak about something, or maybe they are sharing their views or how they spend in the college or in the company of each other. So in the same way, Gandhiji also given the chance, and he is the host of the gathering also. So there he is supposed to speak. There also he was not able to speak. He stood up, but when he was stood up and started to speak, his eyes was blink. His eyes was dazzled and he was not able to speak a single word. So this is the third incident which took place in his life. These are the three times where our writer Mahatma Gandhi failed to speak. And he says that these three incidents which has happened in his life taught him and made him to be a good speaker. And he says that the three incidents taught me, and these three incidents became as a constitutional shyness for me. So it became as a constitutional shyness. He says that is constitutional shyness. That means this silence, the where he was failed, taught him to be where to use and how to use the words. And he says that he has learned the economy of the words and tappuga maatladatam and use the words accurately. And ekkada ee vidhanga maatladalo aa subject takinatvanti vidhanga maatladetvanti vidhanga tanu nechukogaligaru. So